It was greed that lured many of the Europeans to the region. The promise of great wealth from mining drove the early pioneers to fight their way through the hostile terrain and extremes of climate to build settlements here. Part-time philosopher and full-time prospector James Smith hiked through this remote area way back in 1871 and stumbled upon what was described as a mountain of tin. Yielding more than 5.5 million tons of ore, the Mount Bischoff mine elevated the whole area into a mining bonanza and lifted Tasmania from economic stagnation to a state of great prosperity. It's hard to imagine as you walk down the main street of Waratah today that this quiet, relaxed, sleepy village was once a thriving metropolis, boasting nearly 4,000 people and the world's richest tin mine. Those memories are gone and long forgotten, but like most Australian country towns, if you want to know anything about the place, always ask at the local pub. Here she is, folks. A remainder of the past, the historic Bischoff Hotel. It's more than 100 years old. And the hotelier here, he's called Lou. He's a mate of mine, and I tell you what, he knows a bit about the place. G'day, Lou.
G'day, Tim.
Listen, love what you've done at the pub. And I tell you what, the place nowadays is only a shadow of its past.
It certainly was a little busy town, yes.
And all founded on tin and mining.
Yes, and in fact, it was the first ever mine in Tasmania, which led to other exploration of the West Coast, and today, mining is one of its staple industries.
And also based on the waterfall here. Now, that water played a very powerful part in the history of the area.
Well, apart from supplying the townspeople with all their water needs, it also worked for the mine in that it was used to clean the ore. It also drove one of Tasmania's oldest hydroelectricity stations, which is still down there today, but not used, sadly.
You can also see the remnants of buildings here and structures and brick piers, all part of that mining history.
At one time, this whole valley was covered with buildings, all to do with the mining operation, which was very important to Tasmania at the time.
One of the most extraordinary things about the Tarkine is its diversity.